I'm glad you made it to part 6, locations continued. If you haven't seen part 5 about locations, you may want to do that first because this is a continuation of part 5. What we're going to talk about today is Lowe's, Home Depot, and Walmart. All right, Lowe's, Home Depot is what we're going to cover first. And in order to get to Lowe's and Home Depot, you will have to go through a company called Street Eats. Street Eats is an independent company that Lowe's and Home Depot are contracted with in order to run their vendors. Anybody that's a vendor at Lowe's or Home Depot has to go through Street Eats. Street Eats, their link to their website and application and stuff will be found at our website, which will be shown on the next clip here. And then you can also go to our website after all the videos and get all the links to everything you can possibly want. But Street Eats, what they're going to do is they're going to have you do an application. It usually costs some money to even file the application. The drawback to this is they will charge you a rent. They will also be your boss. They will tell you that you work 7 days a week, and they'll tell you that the cart has to be this type of cart, and it has to be your prices. They want to see your prices, your menu, your uniform. They basically control you. So if you're getting into the hot dog cart business to be your own boss, this is not the way to do it, because you would quickly have a boss with Street Eats. Now, let me tell you the upside of this. It's a great income because Lowe's and Home Depot are always busy. But and also keep in mind, Street Eats does not have a staff that goes around and checks their vendors. I have a friend that has 3 locations at Home Depot and Lowe's, and he does very, very, very well with those locations. And he said he's never seen Street Eats. They've never come by. They've never nothing. And he doesn't worry about uniforms, and he's changed his prices without notifying them, and all kinds of stuff. Lowe's and Home Depot have put it in place to avoid any headaches with having to, with managers playing favorites with vendors or whatever. So if you want a secure income as far as without having to do a lot of legwork and finding your own locations, Lowe's and Home Depot are excellent. Plus, they have the potential to make you a great living. The buddy I was telling you that's got 2 locations at Lowe's and 1 at Home Depot, he basically has employees that run the carts for him so that he doesn't have to do everything each day. Now, he and his wife run 1 cart, and then he's got people running 2 other carts. So he's making a considerable amount of money, but he's also having to pay rent for that. And so if he didn't show up one day, or if it's bad weather or whatever the case may be, he still has to pay rent. I don't like having to pay to be somewhere, but if I was going to pay to be somewhere, these are 2 of the locations I'd pay to be. So I don't want to discourage you. I know I sound a little negative about it, but it's just because I don't like a third party who does nothing for me to take part of my income. But you can expect rents to be anywhere from $400 to $1,200. They are negotiable no matter how much they tell you they're not. They are negotiable, and so I'd negotiate a rate with them. Once you've filled out the application and been approved, I would negotiate something with them just because they're going to come back to you and hit you pretty hard. They adjust rents according to the store's volume as far as they don't really adjust the rents, but they give different rents for each place according to that store's volume. So keep that in mind. If the rent's real high, it means it's a high-volume store. You'll also find that any of the Lowe's that have the contractor bay, they are busier, according to a buddy of mine. Now, I've never worked these locations, but I have talked to people that do, and I'm just passing that along to you. Walmart. This is a just a one heck of a place to be. If we could all be at Walmart's, we could retire quickly. I want to tell you how hard it is to get at Walmart, and then I want to tell you how easy it was for one lady. The Walmart, you don't see hot dog vendors out in front of Walmart, and there's a reason, and it's because Walmart doesn't allow it, or at least I've never heard of them allowing it. But here's the trick, and I didn't come up with this. I wish I could credit it to myself, but it wasn't me. But a lady went, got her a hot dog cart, wanted to be at Walmart. I explained to her that that was impossible, And she went to the Humane Society, which she volunteered at. She told them that she wanted to donate a portion of her proceeds to them. They were ecstatic to have her doing that. So she was able to get, I think it was two banners, or two posters and a banner. And she also got a t-shirt and some other stuff. But bottom line is, she decked her cart out for the Humane Society. And then she went and took pictures of her cart and everything to Walmart and talked to the manager and said, listen, we do this to raise funds for the Humane Society. Do you care if we come? And they let her come do it, which has astounded me. Now, what I found out later is that they wanted to ensure that all the profits were going to the Humane Society, which is okay. And let me tell you how she got around that. She told Walmart, yes, we'll give you 100% of the, or we'll give the Humane Society 100% of the proceeds. But like with any charity, and if you've ever been familiar with them, they have a cost to run. I think it was Paul Harvey, if any of y'all remember him, did a story on March of Dimes and all these different charities. And some of the huge charities, less than 10% went to to the charity part of it. The rest went into running the charity, which pays incomes and, you know, pays for all their bigwigs. What she did is she did it in an honest way. She said, okay, I'll give them 100% of the proceeds, or she told them she was, and which meant more than she was currently giving them. But what she did is she went ahead and paid herself, and you can set that number whatever you want it to be. If you want it to be $100 an hour, then set it at $100 an hour. Walmart is probably, you could afford to set it at $250 an hour. And then just don't overstay your welcome. Spend 3 or 4 days a week there, or 2 days a week there, and be done. If you show up 7 days a week, pretty soon it's going to be just a headache for Walmart, and it doesn't look as good. So do it a couple days a week or 3 days a week, and you will make a bunch of money. I don't know that this will work for everyone, because each manager probably has the ability to approve or not approve you being there. So keep that in mind, but don't let it get you discouraged if you want a Walmart, because obviously it can be done. Now, the next part of the series is all the links. All the links that I've told you about, to everybody, to Street Eats, to how to build a cart, everything is going to be this link on the next page. Just go there. It's all free. Take a look at it. Now, also, if you want to, and if you've decided, hey, this business is for me, also make available a, and I'll tell you the benefit to this is how I make $345 a month on water, bottled water, without ever buying the first bottle. So I get all my water free, so all my profits free on the water, which is not included in the $345. Plus, I've made $345 before I've ever sold any bottles. I tell you how I do that. I also tell you how I get free hot dogs. That is no joke. I have a cart that I get 100% free hot dogs on, and they're name brand. One item that makes me $1,450 a month. One item I added to the cart that makes me $1,450 a month. Also, how you can make $4,100 approximately on a commissary, and how I do that. Now, all you have to do is go here, check it out. We will be posting another video on leasing and renting carts, so be sure to check that out also here. You can probably find it quicker at learnhotdogs.com and watch that the final video in this series. I will add videos as necessary. We do a weekly webinar, so please sign up at learnhotdogs.com, and you'll be able to ask me questions. It's all live. It's not canned, and I will help you out any way I can. Whether you buy anything from me now or ever, doesn't matter. I am tickled pink to be able to help you, and I look forward to hearing of your success stories.